Bodhi and Sick Nerd have had PokerStars sponsorships. That's true, man. That's true. What is it that they said? Associating and promoting third-party websites that encourage gambling. But they did say, yeah, no, they said any type of gambling will no longer work with any individuals who participate, advertise, or is associated with any type of gambling interest, real or digital currencies.
I actually got invited by PokerStars as well years ago. I had a sponsorship with them. PokerStars invited me to a tournament in Spain, Barcelona, and I was given poker lessons by professional poker players. I'm not even trolling, by the way. This is years ago. And I ended up leaving the program because they asked me to start streaming it and to start inviting my viewers into PokerStars games with me. And they were like, we'll pay for your buy-in, but everyone's got to pay for their own. And I was like, well, this is really immoral. So I didn't do it anymore. I didn't agree with either Adam or with both Adam, Sick Nerd or Boaty, with doing the PokerStars things. People don't know that. I didn't really tell people.
I mean, I've been offered quite a few opportunities to completely throw my audience under the bus, mate, but I wouldn't do it. I've been offered countless private servers and stuff. Wouldn't you and Boaty get banned if you took the poker sponsorship nowadays? It's kind of a different situation. You can't compare the way a friend handled the .com thing to me and Boaty doing PokerStars. I mean, maybe, though. I don't know what Jagex's stance on it would be, but I don't know. I don't feel that bad about doing the PokerStars thing because, one, my community actually wanted me to take that, and it was good content.
I was offered I think I was offered like $84,000 a year to advertise blackjack and roulette, and I declined it. And I freaking love blackjack and roulette, but that's because I don't know if my viewers will get addicted to gambling and ruin their lives. You know, that's on me, bro. I'll never know, mate. I'll be swimming with my 84 grand, bro. I'll be happy. But gambling is a very fine line, you know.
Is, I think, promoting gambling of anything is inherently immoral anyway, which is, and this is no flame to anyone that has, because it's each person's decision, but I personally didn't want to promote gambling. I got offered the sponsorship for the poker website as well, but I declined it because I didn't want to promote that to my viewers. I'm not trying to be one of those nerds that's taken a moral high ground on something or trying to throw anyone else under the bus or speak bad about anyone else, but personally,
if they're against all gambling, then why the fuck is the jewelry in a thing? And I'm not trying to take, I don't think the jewelry should be removed, but you can't be against all gambling and then have the jewelry in it. Because people gamble with that shit to make a living. Like, it's not intended for that purpose, but let's be fucking real, bro. You go to the fucking jewelry, mate, everyone there is bloody staking their rent money. And you know that's a fact. That's the truth. Everyone does that shit there. So, I mean, where do you draw the line, you know? I don't want the arena removed personally because I think some people probably have fun with it and I wouldn't want to take that away from them. But it is used for gambling, so where do they draw the line, you know?
Asked if I would promote a gambling site. No, never would, man. I turn down, you know, 99% of the sponsorships that reach out to me.
But I don't think I'm ever going to take another one, because despite the fact that I still had permission from my fucking chat to do it multiple times, I still felt bad and do feel bad about doing it to this day, just because I don't like doing that kind of stuff. So I don't think I'm going to take another one regardless.
Yo, Mark, my cat just died and I'm devastated. Yo, I'm sorry to hear that, brother. Bastard was only 5 minutes away from 200 death runes. Oh, fuck your pet on RuneScape. To hell with him. I thought you meant your real cat. Fuck that cat, bruh.
Yo, I got this new song about Fortnite. Catch me in the battle bus, Fortnite. Catch me in the
Two ways to make money on this planet. 2018 mumble rap tracks and Fortnite in the title. Boom, you got everything.
Nah, nah, he needs to die. Unless he's an Iron Man. Hey, buddy. Let's confuse the fuck out of him. This thing's shit anyway, bro. Please don't take him just because you care. Love again. He's the only one for me, Jolie. Alright, cool.
Come on, Ranger. But what is that? Two Addy Axes and 70. Why?
Why 73
water runes and two Addy Axes?
Oh boy, they didn't even have a bottle opener.
Fuck sake! Hey, oh, and then the thing fell over. That's just great.
800,000. So 800,000 people paid. What's 800,000 times? I'm actually going to use a calculator. It's $8 million, right? I'll use a calculator anyway. $8 million. Not including sponsorships or anything like that. And then they fucking milked it and said it was a draw. Even though KSI knocked the cunt out.
I overate a little bit there. I meant to eat twice, but I ate the crumb once, so. Waiting for when I'm looking Oh my god. Okay. I don't know why it was delayed so much. I must have gone to the next tick straight away, but 3428 Gmall. That's the difference that defense makes, I guess. Having no armor on, having full armor on. Beautiful.
I think it's between Sick Nerd and Curse. Unless me and Paul can get renominated, then it's probably gonna be Paul again, I would say. So I've got a feeling it's gonna be between Sid and Curse. They should make it that you can't nominate people that have already won personally. So they might just write that off, but then you kind of waste your nomination.
Dude, I'm not warmed up for this. Come on! This is a troll, bro. How much was it? It's like 200 mil, man. I think it's some kind of bait. He must have inboxed it, you know? What do you mean, good fight?
Modred, can we have a look at the other picture teasers? And we can have Mod Monroe speak about those, because you have some reward.
First off, we have the God Wars dungeon. So on the left, we have the normal God Wars dungeon with the brazier unlit. And the snow effect is, you can kind of see in the picture, and it's on your screen. And then once you've lit the brazier, the snow effect disappears, and your stats are no longer drained. And that, once you've lit it, that's it. When you go to God Wars, your stats will never be drained again.
That is lit.
I want to tell them about the snow effect, because it's rather easy to miss in the pic.
It removes the snow effect.
It does remove the snow effect.
Apart from the effect, it removes the animated overlay thing.
Yeah, that's yes. Sorry, it removes the overlay as well, yeah. And then here we have the Lumbridge Swamp Caves. Mm-hmm. And so again, the picture on the left is, obviously it's a lot darker and you're going to get damaged if you're down there without any light sources. Mm-hmm. And then once you're done, once you've lit that... Yeah, it becomes lit, and you no longer need light source when you go down those caves, and that's the same in the Mole Pit and Cave Horrors for Muscle Harms.
You also, I believe, you don't get the warnings anymore in the scenarios where you would usually need a light source, except from the Cave Horror one, because it also warned you about that Witch Wood icon, which
yeah,
you thought
correct.
Was worth keeping in, because they do hurt quite a bit, actually, if you don't have that icon.
Yes, they do.
Do you know, like, I broke my fucking computer monitor last stream, and I ended shortly after, because I couldn't figure out why it turned off, and I thought the backlight broke. Me and Sophie went out, like, yesterday morning, and, you know, we bought a new monitor, so I could have it, and it wasn't plugged in. So now I have three. The plug fell out.
Wish me luck. 15. Jeez, nice, man. Well done, buddy. A loot chat. We saw a loot. You thought it was Twisted Bow? I didn't get fooled on the Twisted Bow. That's sick, man. Well done, dude. Hey, well done, buddy. Imagine if it was a Twisted Bow. I'd be a little triggered if it was a Twisted Bow, man. But yo, that's awesome, dude. It's just nice to see a drop. That's the first Twisted Buckler I've seen.
It's gonna start a war. You can hear the sirens going off. I can almost hear them coming. It wasn't me!
Players have correctly pointed out that the Firemaking Cape doesn't have a whole lot of buffs on it other than lighting up dark places for you, and this makes it a little less valuable, so we are open to more things what you can do with the Firemaking Cape other than it spawning tinder boxes. Yeah, we're up for more things.
I think, in fairness, with the way most people get the Firemaking Cape these days,
they can probably call it a tinderbox.
That's generally a handy thing in its own without having the cape.
Yeah.
So whether the cape necessarily needs anything is another question, but answers on a postcard.
Absolutely.
That's it, boys. Did the man slander the perp?
Better looking. That's my dad, you know?
What the fuck is happening in my inventory right now?
Honestly, late night shopping at Kmart.
He's such a fit cunt, isn't it?
Hey!
He's so dumb. Like, that should win best clip, because he's just fucking clueless. He's got no idea what's going on, does he?
You look like a fucking goblin. Bastard.
Years older and better look.
Wow, okay. Alright. Yeah, he slammed me there. He really put me in the slammer.
Oh my god, Foe, by the way. Join Foe, see ya. Right. Thanks, boys. Alright, get out if you can, guys. We're still out there. Never mind, we can't go deep wilderness.
Mog isn't a giver, he's a taker. If only you knew, bro. If only you knew. I gifted myself a sub, that's pretty neat. Did you actually? A gold necklace! 500 kills dry! Are you kidding me? Guys, that's 500 kills dry, a cult necklace. What the f-